the Centurion that Pilate would call to get these criminals punished. I was mean and heartless. These criminals, they got what they deserved. I was fearless and I had no emotional attachment to them. I would grab the whip and I would hit them so much until there was a pool of blood on my foot. Nothing, no remorse. I didn't feel sorrow. They got what they deserved. Then, I heard of this Jesus, so-called King of the Jews. I had to get everybody. I got all the Roman soldiers together. This was too good to pass up. So once we received them, we beat them, just like every other criminal. And then once we got them into the headquarters, we ripped off his clothes and put a robe on him. We made a crown of thorns. Every king should have his crown. We all laughed at him. I spat in his face a couple times. And I kneeled down and I would say, "Hail the King of the Jews." Once again, I would grab the bamboo stick and I would hit him on the head a couple more times where his crown was, just to make sure it wouldn't fall down as he carried his cross. Then it was time to take him to the place of schools where we laid and hung every criminal out there. So as we got there, he was already beaten and we had already crucified two thieves before him. So here we go, we get his first arm and we nailed his hand to the cross. And then as soon as I grabbed the second arm, I could already imagine how he's gonna try to fight it. I could imagine how much resistance he's gonna try to push away the nails, just like the two thieves before him. But when I grabbed his hand and I stretched it to the cross, he opened his hand, willingly letting me hammer the nail through his hands. What was that? I've never seen that before. Then I moved to his feet and I nailed his feet afterwards. Almost like he was willing to let me pierce his hands and feet. And then as we hung him on the cross, we started gambling for his clothes. And I remember him just saying, "Father, why have you forsaken me?" We all laughed at him when he was saying, "Save yourself." Even the people, the Jews that were passing by, were laughing at him saying it. And then for about 3 hours, the sky turned dark. And then on the third hour, he said it again. He said, "Father, why have you forsaken me?" And that moment he died. And when he died, that very moment, the earth began to shake. The rocks, they started to split all around me, and the tombs were being opened. The dead was being raised to life. Truly, this man was the Son of God. I looked at my Roman soldiers, we all trembled in fear. What was that? How did we really crucify the Son of God? Ever since that day, I will never be the same again. I will forever be changed. Jesus was truly the Son of God.